Hey guys, welcome to another Hostinger Academy tutorial. My name is Kastutis and today we will go over using SSH to manage the files on your hosting plan. So without any further ado, let's get to it. While the hPanel Symbol File Manager is great for managing your files, you can oftentimes run into some errors when extracting or transferring larger files. These errors can be caused by an unstable internet connection. So this is where SSH or Secure Shell Protocol comes into play. And I know, using the commands to transfer or extract your files might seem daunting at first. No worries though, with the help of this tutorial and a bit of practice, anyone can get a hang of this super powerful tool. So let's get to it. There are two main ways you can initiate an SSH connection. First would be with the help of an SSH client such as PuTTY. The second option is using your operating system's built-in terminal. Since I'm using Windows 10, I will be setting everything up using command prompt. The process itself is basically identical on any platform, so you will still be able to follow along even if this is not what you are using. Let's begin by navigating to your account's SSH section. You can find it by scrolling a bit down. Once you find yourself here, it is super important to check if you have managed SSH access enabled, as otherwise you will not be able to connect. Since SSH is a command line tool, a connection to your hosting account will be executed via command. Lucky for us, the exact command is already written out here, so all we need to do is copy it and paste it into our command prompt window. Once you run this command, you will be prompted to enter your password. The password we will be using here is identical to your FTP account's password. When you begin to enter it, you will notice that no characters are actually showing up on screen. No worries, this is completely normal and your SSH client is not frozen. This is simply done for security purposes and you can continue entering your password as before. At this step, you might be prompted by another security message asking if you're sure that you would like to connect to this server. Simply select yes to continue. Congratulations, you are now connected to your hosting plan via SSH. SSH is a super powerful tool with tons of different commands that you can run with it. Since we're just starting out, let's focus on a few that we'll be using the most. Let us begin by using the ls command. Simply type ls into the terminal and press enter. Ls simply lists all the file names in the directory which we are currently located in. But how do you know which directory we are in? This is where pwd is handy. PWD or print working directory lets us know exactly which location we are currently working in. So far so good, but how do we change our active directory? Using cd, of course. Cd or change directory lets us move between different folders. I want to open my domains folder, so to do this I would need to type cd domains and press enter. You can use the cd command to navigate directly to your desired location by using its full path. A super handy tool in this situation is using the tab key to autocomplete the command. When used with cd, pressing it once will autocomplete your command, choosing out the only possible option. If there are more than one option available, pressing it twice will list them for you. Let's navigate to a folder which I created in my domains directory named backups, as this is where I uploaded my backup archive. Now running the command ls, you can see that my backup is indeed uploaded here. There are multiple formats that can be used when dealing with compressed files. Most popular are .tar, .tar.gz, .zip, and .rar. Different formats require the use of different commands, so you will be able to find them all on the right side of the screen. My backup is compressed using the .zip file format. To extract it, I will be running the unzip command. It is super simple. All I need to do is type unzip and my backup file name. Once the archive is decompressed, I will no longer be needing the original .zip file on my hosting plan. So to save space, let's remove it. To remove a file, we'll use the rm command. Awesome! Lastly, let us move the backup files to the proper location. To move files, we'll be using the nv command. Using this command can seem a bit tricky as you will need to enter the full path to your destination. No worries though. While it definitely takes some time, you can easily get the hang of navigation using SSH, making listing out the full path quite simple. Make sure to begin your path listing with /home followed by another /. Then pressing the tab key will help you reach our destination. And there you have it! This is all it takes to get started using SSH. And what's super amazing about this tool is that there are tons of different commands you can be using. So simply listing everything in one video is not possible. No worries though, check the video description below. You'll find links to some amazing articles with more super useful SSH commands. So check them out. Did you find this tutorial helpful? Let me know by smashing the like button. And of course, stay subscribed for more amazing tutorials like this one. Perhaps you know some amazing SSH scripts that could help others. Share them in the comments below. I'd love to check them out. And until next time, have a good one.